Very good evening to all of you. I know it's already very late, but I'm going to present my paper in Energy Environment Policies in India and Contextualize the National Action Plan on Climate Change. I worked this paper individually with my colleague, Mr. Amir Bashir Bazal. He is also going to come here, but some official reason he is not able to attend this conference. So I'm going to present this paper. Okay, this is the scope of my presentation. In this, first of all, I want to give a general introduction about the energy and environment policies in India. The energy and environment policies. You know, environment is not a new thing in India. Our government is very much concerned about these policies right from the three decades or four decades earlier also. There are so many policies like environment conservation, forest conservation, policies regarding that the water pollution, air pollution, land pollution. These are the local issues on which the government has launched their own policies. But when the government has come towards the energy policies, is taking a part. This is a shifting of policies. As a theme of the today's workshop is also the shifting of science and the changing policies. Like this, my paper is also present on this. Okay, so National Conservation Strategy and Policy Statement on Environment and Development that is launched in 1992. In this policy statement, government has shifting their policy from the local issues to the global issues, global like the energy security issues. Now, what are the things that that pressure the government to think about the energy issues? Okay. The evolution of these policies I have divided in two phases. First is the initial phase. The initial phase having the start from 1990 when the liberalization is introduced in India. Liberalization introduced the industries, it increases the rate of economy in India that triggers the many policies. Like there is a policy about energy security, energy conservation and the thing. Starting in 2000 when the first Energy Conservation Act has come in 2001. According to this act, the government has forced or government has launched the policy that there is a urgent need to secure the present energy so that we can produce, and there is also an urgent need for to find out the alternative fuels other than the coal, because we can't rely on the coal itself, which is a major emitter of the greenhouse gases. Under this Energy Conservation Act in 2001, the another Bureau of Energy Efficiency is again launched in 2002 by Government of India. The Bureau of Energy Efficiency's major objective is to check out the energy efficiency of the industries, mechanisms, and after this, the government has launched the Electricity Act in 2003. The major objective of this 2003 Act is to secure the electricity so that the energy sector can get the maximum of energy, electricity from this sector. And in, if you go through the 10-5-year plan also, the government is more concerned about the energy issue, the production of energy, not about the consumption. There is a sustainable way of development also in the 10-5-year plan, but not about the climate change. The government is not implicitly giving an effort toward the climate change, toward the carbon dioxide emissions. Now, the second phase is a point of departure. Now, how the climate change come in the frame? The Integrated Energy Policy that is launched in 2006. In this policy, government shows its concern towards the climate change, towards the emissions of the CO2. And this is also shown in the 11th five-year plan where the sustainable development was also come in the frame. And then also, these all things triggered the government to launch the National Action Plan on Climate Change. This is the first policy launched by Indian government about the climate change. That is in 2008. What are the other factors that pushes the government to launch the National Action Plan? In the international level also, there are the national negotiations, international negotiations are going on continuously. But when the international negotiation come into the high point, that is from the COP13 held in Bali, and the Body Action Plan has come out. That is in 2007. In this year, Body Action Plan has also launched an ad hoc working group on long-term cooperation action. These groups work to find out the in the long-term ways about the emissions rate. In COP15, again a very a year when India gave its commitment that they are going to reduce the emission intensity of GDP by 20 to 45% up to 2020 at the level of 2005. Then COP16, again there is a negotiation about the emission cut between the developing countries and the developed countries. And these things, these changes, help to develop the National Action Plan on Climate Change. And if you will go through all the eight elements, these eight elements are rely on the sustainable development. It means our policies are developing, our energy security is there, but all these things, we are developing these policies by keeping the mind about the sustainable development, because we have to conserve our natural resources, not for ourselves, but for our upcoming generation also. The eight core missions are the solar mission, enhanced energy efficiency, sustainable habitat, water, sustaining the Himalayan ecosystem, Green India, sustainable agriculture, strategy, knowledge for climate change. Now, how I analyze these things? It's a policy, and for this, I want to introduce the analytical model. There's how the public policy passes through the four stages. Okay, so there are four stages. One is identify the problem and setting an agenda. It's a very first stage because you have to identify the problem. Where we are lacking? That is a problem. For this, we have to adopting a particular policy. Now, whether this policy is implementing or not, that is a third stage. Then the evaluation of the policy. For this, I have used the Kingdom's model. Kingdom's model that is discovered by the Johns W. Kingdon in 1984. It's an analytical model and it passes through the first stage, that is the setting of agenda. The next is how the Kingdon models work. The policy agenda is a list of issues or problems on which the policy maker and decision maker pay attention. And there should be some problem on which the policy makers will work. If there is no issue, how will they provide a policy? So first of all, you have to find out the problems. And in this Kingdom's model, the analysis is done by there are three main streams. When these three streams merge together, only after that the policy comes out. The first stream is the problem stream, second is policy, third is the political streams. In the problem streams, you have to identify the problems. What are the problems? For example, in the case of National Action Plan, there is a problem of there are certain events, natural disasters are there, flooding is there, high precipitation is there, drought is there. These are the problems which force the government to think about it, why these are happening. Like this, there's a policy stream also. I have discussed the problem stream. Now the policy stream, the IPCC AR4 2007, which was done in 2007, has clearly explained with full certainty that there is a climate change. And we have to take further steps to control this. And for this, in 14th Lok Sabha questionnaire also, the government people have shown their concern in the Lok Sabha by raising the 48 questions towards the climate change. But before this 14th Lok Sabha period, in 13th Lok Sabha, people were not more much concerned about this climate change issue. There are hardly 11 to 13 questions that were questioned towards the climate change issue. Otherwise, right from the 14th Lok Sabha, people are more aware, and the government people are aware, their questions are rising. And in this year, 2007 itself, the Prime Minister organized an expert committee constituted. Under the Prime Minister Commission, this expert committee studied the climate change impact and adaptations and mitigation patterns for the climate change. Then the political streams come out with the 14 Lok Sabha questions. The political streams, they worked out on this, and the expert committee constituted, they present their report to the Prime Minister, and all these things working together. Now when all these streams are working, they result in the National Action Plan on Climate Change. This is a time in 2008 June. Now this is an analysis that I have done on by the help of Kingan's model. Okay, as I have explained that the problem, I have categorized in the three different time frame. First is 1991 to 2002, 2002 to 2007, and 2007 onward. In 1991 to 2000, the problem are generally local issues like the water pollution, air pollution, wildlife conservation, biodiversity. These are the local issues. In 2002, the problem is shifting from the local to natural environmental issues like the energy security, because we need energy to develop our industries, to increase our economy. And from 2007 onwards, the shift is towards the climate change, because we have seen the problems like flooding, drought, extreme event. We are not sure that whether these are because of the climate change, but more or less, because of the IPCC AR4 report, it has merged out that there is a problem because of the climate change. So government has to look after this thing. This issue can't be ignored. Now the policy stream. The sustainable development policies with no climate policies there in till 1991-2000. Liberalization was there, but still then government is not concerned about the climate change. In 2002-2007, sustainable development policies are introduced. The agriculture was a main issue in that also. The climate change is not standing in that in this category till then. In 2007 onward, the climate policies are available there, but these policies are developed on the basis of sustainable development. Then the politics enter into the politics. In 1991 to 2000, the poverty eradication is a major issue for the government. The basic need of the people is a major issue at that time. There is a need of food, there is a need of land, there is a need of pure water is there at that time. So at that time politics is totally diverted towards these things. Whereas in 2002-2007, it is about, as we are going through the industrialization phases at 2002-2007 onwards, there is a more need about the sustainable development is the main agenda at that time also. Then the after 2007 onward, the more in the Lok, as I explained the Lok Sabha questionnaire also, the people are more concerned about the political issues is coming out in the climate change. Now the politicians are also coming out for this climate change issue. Now what? In the policy entrepreneur, Kingdoms has introduced this word as policy entrepreneur, who drive these policies and suggest the government officials whether they are accepted or not. So in this 1991 to 2002 period, local advocacy groups are there. Lack of national and international research on climate change is there. Means at that time, no one is interested from India. No one is interested in this thing. Whereas in 2002 onward, not sufficient research on regional impact on climate change is there. Third assessment report focus on climate change with lack of regional researches. And in 2007 onwards, after the release of IPCC AR4 report, there is a certain projection and the local research focus on the climate change. This is my analysis. Analysis in earlier year, this is a lack of climate policies, whereas in the 2007 there is the policy entrepreneurs meeting national targets. There is the national targets at that time also, there is a production of more and more energy so that they can approach towards the industrialization and fulfill the needs of energy for the local people and for the at the national level only. But this problem analysis at the 2007 onward, it converted into the climate change policy was adopted. And this is my concluding remarks for this work, that policy window offers an exposed analysis of the policy. However, the role of the policy instrument is critical to sustain the continuous improvement and implementation of the policy plan, because the policy makers play a major role while driving the policies, because it's up to them how they will take the problem, how they will take the issues and politics together to make a correct policy so that government can't ignore that policy. Now, and second important thing for India perspective is that sustainable development policies will survive more in future itself, because most of the policies are developed from the sustainable development, are rely on the sustainable development. Sustainable development has helped in achieving the development and climate goals simultaneously at least cost. Thank you so much.